Hello friends, this is the second video in the Nobel Prize series, and what we are going to talk about is Nobel Prize for Physics. This year's Nobel Prize for Physics was given for the detection of gravitational waves. This prize was given to the three people, Rainer Weiss. Second person was Gary C. Barish. The third personality was Kip S. Hoom. Now what we need to know is that what is this gravitational wave and why is it so important? This idea of gravitational wave was given by Albert Einstein. Einstein in 1916 in his theory of relativity, where he was explaining that gravity is not a force, but it is a kind of a distortion in space-time continuum. Now, I will make it easy for you. He considered space as a fabric in 2D. If we consider it as a fabric in 2D, he said that whenever big body is kept on this, if we keep it on this, what will happen is that a sag will take place. Thus, it will be seen like this. If a body is kept on this space-time continuum. And because of this sag, what happens is that any body, if it is moving from this direction to this direction, it has to move diagonally, then it will always be attracted toward this distortion in the space-time and will start rotating around this body. So this was the explanation given by Albert Einstein about space-time continuum fabric. And he explained that these gravitational waves are nothing but they are fast ripples passing through this space-time continuum fabric. These ripples are somewhat like this, and these ripples are created because of two reasons. And these reasons of the generation of gravitational wave may be a large cosmic event. Large cosmic event in space. This event may be a supernova explosion, which is the explosion taking place when a star explodes and ends its life. Then it may be when two stars are revolving around each other. Or two black holes are revolving around each other. And then they finally merge together. So because of this big cosmic event, what will happen is a lot of ripples will be produced. These ripples are the manifestation of the energy released, and hence these ripples will travel in the space-time continuum as if they are the ripples which are traveling in a pond when a stone is thrown in the pond. The ripples which are shown, which are created in these ponds, are the similar ripples which we can see in space-time continuum. Thus, now we know that what was gravitational wave. Gravitational wave. But this was only predicted and it was not found out by Einstein, and it was predicted in 1916 and 17. But this year, this prize was given to the scientists, all the three scientists, because of detecting these waves. The detection of these waves was done by LIGO. The full form of LIGO is Laser Interferometer Gravitational Wave Observatory. It's an observatory which is present on the earth, which is there in order to detect this kind of distortion in the space-time continuum and the gravitational waves which are created due to it. So these gravitational waves travel, and when they hit the earth, what will happen because of this space-time continuum is that earth will move here and this side. This will cause squeezing and relaxation of earth. Although the intensity of these waves which reach the earth is very low. Why is it very low? I'll tell you, because the gravitational waves which we read this year were the gravitational waves which were created 1.3 billion years ago, when two black holes merged together, and thus it has reached Earth in such a long time, and hence it has lost lot of intensity, and hence the squeezing and relaxation is very difficult to detect, and hence we need very sophisticated instruments in order to detect this. These sophisticated instruments are in the forms of mirrors. These are parallel mirrors, and a laser is being projected on them, and this laser is projected to a observatory. Okay, and what happens is that even if slightest of variation in the position of this mirror takes place, this will not meet at a single point. The distortion will come, and this distortion can be observed from the observer. This shows that there is distortion which points out towards the existence of gravitational waves. This kind of arrangement was done in order to understand, and this kind of LIGO observatory was made in two places. One was Hanford Observatory, and the second was Livingston Observatory. Both of these observatories are in USA. Although there are few more observatories which are involved in this kind of a work. One is GEO, that is in Germany. Other is Virgo, that is in Italy. And one more is Karga. This is in Japan. One more thing important to know about this LIGO is that a next LIGO is coming in India as well, and it will be coming in Hingoli district of Maharashtra. So India will also be involved in this gravitational wave observation. Now when we talk about the second Nobel Prize, it was in chemistry. And it was given for cryo-electron माइक्रोस्कोप. दिस प्राइज वॉज गिवन टू थ्री पीपल, जैक्स बाबोशे. सेकेंड पर्सन वॉज जोखिम फ्रैंक. And the third person was Richard Henderson. We need to understand that what is microscopy, what is electromicroscopy, and what is cryo. So these three terms we need to understand. Microscopy is a technique to watch very small things. Now, if we look into the history of microscopy, we know that first telescope, which is used to be, this is an instrument which is used to read far away objects, it was given by Hans Lippershey. And a famous, very famous scientist, Galileo, was the one who changed this telescope, reversed this telescope, and got to know that he can use this kind of a arrangement of lenses in order to study very small things, and this was the starting of microscopy. Then later we see this microscopy, the efficiency had to be increased. And for which microscopy moved from light microscopy to electron microscopy. What's the benefit of this electron microscopy? That the size of electron is less and hence it can penetrate to a larger extent and give a better resolution. And what's the meaning of cryo? Cryo means very low temperature. So the total now is cryo electron microscopy. So this helps to freeze the biomolecules. Now, why there is a requirement of freezing the biomolecules? The requirement is because biomolecules are in movement, constant movement, and hence a constant study, a particularistic study is not possible about the biomolecules. Hence, when we freeze them, we can have new images which can be used for further research. So, this cryo-electron microscopy is a particular kind of electron microscopy where freezing is required for the biomolecules in order to get high resolution biomolecule pictures. Third field for which this Nobel Prize is given is medicine. And in medicine, this prize was given for molecular mechanism involved in circadian rhythm. And this prize was given again to three people. Jeffrey C. Hall, second was M. Rochdash, and the third was M. W. Young. Now a question comes to the mind that what is this circadian rhythm? This circadian rhythm is nothing but our 24 hour biological clock. This clock governs our behavior, our everything, our metabolism, our sleep cycle, our hormone level, our body temperature, in order to maintain our body for different phases of the day. Different phases of the day are, our body gets ready because of the circadian rhythm. So it is affecting our body temperature. It is affecting our hormone level. It is affecting our behavior, our sleep, and our metabolism. Thus, this is a very important rhythm which needs to be known. So, these are the people who made us aware that what's the importance of this circadian rhythm, and they did it by understanding a period gene. They isolated a gene in order to understand this, because of this gene, this circadian rhythm is governed, and this period gene they found out in fruit flies. This question may be asked that which was the organism on which they isolated this circadian rhythm gene, which was called period gene, these were the fruit flies. Last year also, this circadian rhythm was in use when blue LED lights were discovered. Blue LED lights. It was said that these blue lights are also affecting our circadian rhythm. Circadian rhythm. How are they affecting the circadian rhythm is that this blue light is generally during the day having a very good effect on us because it increases our metabolism. But because of the excessive lightings around us, now what is happening that even during night, because we have lights in our home and that is emitting this blue wavelength is creating the problem. Blue wavelength of light happens, it affects the secretion of melatonin. This hormone was named last year, that this melatonin secretion is affected by the blue wavelength, which is responsible for the circadian rhythm's control, and hence our circadian rhythm is not being properly maintained because of the presence of blue wavelength around us or blue lights around us. The fourth field for which a Nobel Prize is given is literature. And this year's prize was given to a man named Kazuo Ishiguro. By his name, we may think that he is from Japan, but he is a British citizen. And he is writing, his writings are said to have great emotional force. Few of his books are, the first book is Remains of the Day. And his second great work is Never Let Me Go. The next field for which we see a Nobel Prize is given is that is for peace. I already told you in the last lecture that Nobel Peace Prize is not given in Sweden, it is given in Oslo. And this year's Peace Prize was given to ICANN. The full form of ICANN is International Campaign to Abolish Nuclear Weapons. And as by the name we can see, their primary function is that they draw people's attention for the use of this nuclear weapon, and they want a treaty-based prohibition. this treaty-based prohibition will be achieved by their treaty on prohibition of nuclear weapons. Treaty on prohibition of nuclear weapons. This is the treaty which was created by nuclear. Now, sometimes a question is also asked that what kind of organization is this ICAN? This is a civil society coalition. And it is working towards the eradication of the use of nuclear weapons. Abolish the nuclear weapons. And lastly, when we talk about economics, I explained it to you that in economics it's not the Nobel Prize, it is Swarjee's Riksbank Award, which was started in the year 1968. Otherwise, all other prizes were given before it from 1901. But this year's Nobel Prize was given to Richard Heller. And his Nobel Prize was given for his study in behavioral economics. Now, what is this behavioral economics? This behavioral economics deals with the behavior of the people and how these behaviors are affected or are being affected by the economics effect on the behavior. So, in this, he talked about a principle of nudging. Nudging can be easily understood in a situation where we see cashback. Today, we see a situation where many of the companies are giving us a cashback, and because of these cashbacks, what we are doing is that we go for buying these kind of things even when we don't need it because we are getting cashback. So, if I read the definition of this, it is an economic action in which small stimuli are provided to influence people's behavior. Nudges work at an individual level, but they are also used by the company. So, these kind of incentives, some stimuli which are given to us in order to affect our economic behavior can be called as nudging. He also suggested that when we talk in terms of economics or in terms of our savings, what is happening is that our short-term temptations, they are driving us and they prevent us from saving for a better future. This means that when we have money in our pockets, we spend that money in wasteful consumption, and then what we are having is the crunch of money in the future. This is a kind of a behavior which is being seen, and this was studied by this person, Richard Heller, in his study. Another concept he talks about is mental accounting. He says that everybody is doing what? When they are accounting for their expenses, what we account for? We account for A expenses, B expenses. So, what we are doing is that if money is wasted for, is spent for purpose A and other amount of money is spent for the purpose B, what we do is that we account them separately in our mind, compartmentalized accounting is done in our mind, and we don't see a combined effect it is having on our expenditure. So, this is the problem, that we don't see the larger picture. Thus, he was pointing out that these kind of behavior controlling techniques are being done in economics, which change our economic behavior and which change our actions. So, this was all about the Nobel Prizes for this year, and thank you.